Okay, hello everyone. Today we are going to talk about position-dependent optical isolator and how one can make such an isolator. But first, let's have a look on Faraday isolator, or the simplest and the first optical isolator. Let's assume we have a not polarized light. It's coming through the polarizer, in this case vertical polarizer, then it's vertically polarized and passed through the Faraday crystal, which is such that rotates the light at 45 degrees. Then we have a polarizer at 45 degrees, so this light pass. Let's look at the light on the way back. It's not polarized light. Passing through the first polarizer, it's 45 degrees polarized. But now, passing through the Faraday crystal, which is a non-reciprocal crystal, once we are moving through the magnetic field, now it's in the opposite magnetic field. So the result will not be vertical polarized, but it's another 45 degrees adding to the first polarization. So it will be 90 degrees polarized, and then it will be blocked by the second polarizer. So it means light is passing in one direction, and it's blocked in the other direction. This is optical isolator. But this optical isolator has some negative parts. The first is that half of the light, you see how the light in this direction is lost. And the second is that this optical isolator works for vertical polarization. So if I only put a vertical polarization, then I will not lose it. But if I put a horizontal polarization, then I lose it. So the question is, can we have an optical isolator that allowed all of the lights to pass in one direction independently from its polarization and block it all the lights in the opposite direction? Okay, after seconds I'll show how to do it, but the first I'll need the combination of Faraday rotator and half-wave plate. So, if I start from vertical polarization, put it through the Faraday rotator rotates it in 45 degrees. Then a half-wave plate that's rotated at this angle with respect to this polarization. So it means it will come out horizontally polarized. The other way around, if I put a horizontal polarization, then it goes to 45 degrees, because this is reciprocal. But passing through the Faraday rotator, it won't go to the vertical, but it rather go to the horizontal polarization, because this is non-reciprocal device. This device, I will write it in the following way, in the next figure, which means if I pass through the orientation of the arrow, I will change the polarization from horizontal to vertical, or vice versa. But if I pass on the opposite way, against the magnetic field, nothing will change. It will not change the polarization. Okay, so now we can introduce the position-dependent optical isolator. Assume we have the following scheme. Put the light on vertical polarization from port 1, and then put it on the beam splitter. The beam splitter is such that this polarization pass in this direction, then pass opposite to the non-reciprocal rotator, so it's conserved, come here, reflect from a mirror, reflect from another mirror, then pass through this L box which represents polarizer, which is vertical polarizer, so nothing changed on the light, nothing changed again over here, because it's against the blue arrow, come here, reflect from the mirror, come through port 2. So start from this port, all the light is transferred to this port. Now, the other polarization, instead of vertical, now we have a horizontal polarization. Horizontal polarization is reflected from the beam splitter, go to the mirror, then pass through this device, which now is in the blue array direction, so it changed the polarization, but then pass through the polarizer, which is vertical polarizer, reflected from a mirror, reflected from another mirror, pass again through the one really local rotator, which is in the same direction, so change again the polarization. Then it's reflected from the leader. Go to port 2. So all the light coming here, go over here, and the polarization is conserved. Let's see the white coming back, starting from port 2, and use this polarization. Let's pass over here, reflect from the mirror, then transfer to the other polarization, but now the polarizer pocket and the white doesn't go to port 1, so it's isolated for the other polarization. Put it from port 2, come to the beam splitter, now it's reflecting its direction. Nothing happened because it's against the blue arrow. Come here, reflect from the mirror, reflect from the mirror, but it's absorbed from the polarizer. Now white goes back to port 1. So it's optical isolator. And this is working for the two polarization, from horizontal, from vertical, and from horizontal polarization. So any polarization is a combination of horizontal and vertical, so it means this device will be optical isolator for arbitrary polarization. All of the light will pass in one direction and all of the light will be blocked in the opposite direction. The critical moment here is that for vertical polarization and from horizontal polarization, the two light beams pass the same optical path. So one passes it in this direction and the other passes it. Sorry, this one passes it in this direction and the other one passes it in this direction. But basically, it's the same optical path, so it means no phase difference between two polarizations, which is crucial for this kind of independent optical isolator. Thank you for the attention. Bye.